not look at law as a means of making money, look at law as an instrument for securing justice to people. This is a quote by Prashant Bhushan, Senior Advocate at Supreme Court of India. That being said, if you are someone who wants to serve people by fighting for justice, believe in truth, and who wants to protect the interests of people, a career in law might be the answer. At Hello Study Global, we inform and teach people about the career path which they should take and help them achieve their goal. So in this series, Career Goals, brought to you by Hello Study Global, we will take you through all the details you need in order to pursue a higher education abroad in order to become a lawyer. Good communication skills, strong logical and analytical skills, and eye for detail and confidence are some of the qualities required for this profession. So, if you have already decided to opt for this, we can start working towards it. Let's begin with the first step. You're free to choose any stream after class 10th. There is no specific stream required to pursue a degree in law, and students from all streams can opt for this career. Generally, students who want to pursue law right after 12th take up humanities or commerce streams. Some of the popular subjects for students aspiring for law are political science, legal studies, economics, history, and psychology. These subjects are recommended because they help you form a base for the subjects taught in law schools, and some of these are beneficial in providing an insight to school students about the legal system of the country. Step 2. After diploma, aim for earning an undergraduate degree. After finishing high school, proceed on to higher education or post-secondary studies. Any undergraduate degree works well for law school. For example, BTech, BA, BSc, BBA, BCom, etc. You're not obliged to obtain your initial undergraduate degree at the university where the law school is located. It is better to choose the institution that is best fit for your initial degree. In order to qualify to be accepted into law school, most law schools require the completion of equivalent of at least 3 full-time years or a complete degree. Even if your law school does not require it, your application will be more competitive if you have completed your undergraduate degree. Step 3. Write the LSAT, which stands for Law School Access Program Test. This is a standardized test created and administered by the LSAC, an independent non-profit organization based in the US. Nearly all Canadian and US law schools require the standard LSAT. The standard LSAT is held in many countries throughout the world. Though there are specially designed LSAT for entry into law school located in India, and the specially designed Spanish language LSAT for law school located in Puerto Rico. In Canada and the US, the test is held up to 9 times a year, starting from the month of June and ending till April. Step 4. Apply to law schools. Do the research to determine the law schools for which you should apply. There are 18 common law schools in Canada and hundreds more in the US and around the world. While choosing a law school, you will consider many things, including the size of the school, the type of law it specializes in, the composition of the student body and faculty, and the philosophy of the school. In particular, you must also consider whether you are likely to gain admission to that particular school based on your grades, LSAT score, and other accomplishments and attributes. Step 5. Earn your degree. Depending upon the country and the region you choose to study in, the curriculum and length of the course may vary. For example, in considerable parts of USA and Canada, the first level common law degree is the Juris Doctor or JD, which takes 3 years to complete. It is an undergraduate degree program. The first year is mostly similar in most of the law schools of USA and Canada. Students take introductory courses in subjects such as criminal law, constitutional law, property law, and contracts law. This is followed by summer break internships, specialized courses, and many more. In the third year and the last year, you can opt for student exchange programs and get involved in a leadership role in clubs, committees, journals, or other extracurricular opportunities at the law school. Last and the final step after graduation is to get licensed to practice law. completion of a law degree alone is not sufficient to permit a candidate to practice law, that is, work as a lawyer. In order to be admitted to the bar, you must also write and pass the provisional bar exam and either articling or completing the law practice program. Articling is the phase of your formal legal education and occurs prior to being licensed to practice law. Licensing candidates may choose to either article or complete the law practice program LPP in order to satisfy the experiential training component of the lawyer licensing process. Licensing candidates are admitted to the bar after successfully writing the barrister and solicitor examinations. The barrister examination assesses knowledge of law in the practice areas of public law, criminal procedure, family law, and civil litigation. Finally, you can get recruited as a lawyer and can start working in possibly one of the broad fields like law in public interest or private practice or as a government attorney, etc. We have come to the end of this video. Tell us about your thoughts in the comment section below, and if you liked what you saw, then consider subscribing to our channel and hitting the bell icon for the latest updates and notifications.